Did you volunteer to be one of the pallbearers?
No, I was actually asked if I'd like to volunteer, and I think that was like the greatest thing they could ask me to do, because Wen Yongke has been a very close and dear friend to me.
You were asked by who?
Come again?
Who asked you to volunteer?
My managers asked me. Yeah, they sent a mass message out to ask who wanted to attend Wen Yongke's sending off. So I said, yeah, I would like to. And the next message that came to me is, would you like to be one of the pallbearers? So I was actually very delighted and very happy.
What's your fondest memory of me?
Just too many.
Maybe you could just say one, you know, maybe about your last interview.
Oh, I think it would be really funny to share this with you guys. We talk most outside of filming, and so I think one time we were changing out of our outfits and we were all getting ready to go home, and I think it was a really tough day. I couldn't do some of the scenes, and he would say, you know, I'll share with you this story. There was this monk and a disciple that were crossing a river, but then they met this very pretty lady who needed their help. So the lady asked this monk if she could help, if he could help. So the monk said, okay, fine, I'll carry your stuff and I'll carry you across the river. So the disciple was very unhappy, but then he actually kept it inside of him, and they passed many villages, and it came to a point where the monk actually asked, say, is there something you want to ask me? So the disciple said, yes, you know, I thought we took a vow of celibacy, you know, we're not supposed to be touching women or doing different things. He said, yes, I know, but I helped her across the river and I left her there. I've moved on, but you are holding this grudge or this unhappiness with you. See, in life, we should actually just do what we need to do and just let it be and move on to our lives. We should not actually hold bad grudges or hold unhappiness in our hearts. And I think that is that one thing that will take me throughout life, you know, that I can apply to just about anything.
Do you remember what was your last interaction with him?
I think it was during the 30th anniversary of Chinese drama that we met, and I saw that he had lost quite a bit of weight, that he wasn't his usual jovial self. But I didn't ask, and we just looked at each other and we just nodded, and I think that for me was more than how are you, and, you know, are you getting on fine, you know? But that was, he knew what I was thinking, and he assured me that he was all right, just with a simple nod. And
would you said that you couldn't say your final goodbye to him?
Yes and no, but my relationship with Wen Yongke goes beyond that physical contact or meeting. You know, he has always had this liking for me, and I mentioned before, whenever he sees me, he'll call me handsome, you know. But he'll always end it off with something to bring me down, bring me back to earth, and say, but God is fair, you need to improve on your Mandarin. So that's Wen Yongke for you.
So do you think Singapore TV has lost, you know, a real icon?
Oh yeah, for sure, for sure. I think we have enough memories of Wen Yongke. We have those who have known him, those who have gotten to know him or worked with him, have enough things to last them a lifetime. Like for me, I have all the memories and it's been good. All good.
Personally, what's your favorite role?
I think I really liked it when he played, I can't remember the title of the show, but it was the one where he played this kind of like unscrupulous, devious father of Rayan. It really showed a different side of him. You know, he's used to playing all the good, goofy roles, but this one really showed a different layer of the character that he's played. And I think he actually did a lot of homework and took a very daring step. So I saw a different part of Wen Yongke, and I've told him before, and like I said, I'm sad. I don't have him there when I need him anymore, but I have enough good memories of him, and I've been honored to be a part of his sending off.